Hello friends, something is wrong at the edge of our solar system. In the vast frozen darkness beyond the last known planet, entire worlds are being pulled by an invisible force. Their orbits are twisted, clustered together in a way that defies physics. It's as if they're all dancing to the tune of a silent puppeteer, with a grip so powerful, it's controlling the chaos from the shadows. Astronomers now believe that Puppeteer is real, a colossal, unseen planet, hiding in the dark. And the greatest hunt in modern astronomy has begun. Our story begins at the boundary of everything we thought we knew. 8 planets circling a single star in a cosmic rhythm studied for centuries. The final sentinel of this familiar system is Neptune, a beautiful, violent world of swirling blue storms and winds that shatter the sound barrier. It's a true giant, packing the mass of 17 Earths, orbiting nearly 3 billion miles from the sun's warmth. For a long time, Neptune felt like the wall at the end of the universe. Beyond it, we assumed there was only darkness and scattered frozen debris. But in 1992, that assumption was shattered. Astronomers spotted the first object in a vast, hidden realm they had long suspected was there. It was our introduction to the Kuiper Belt. Think of it as a colossal cosmic junkyard, a donut-shaped ring of icy bodies stretching from Neptune's orbit out to about 50 times the distance from the Earth to the Sun. This is the Kuiper Belt, filled with thousands, if not millions, of frozen relics, ancient building blocks that never quite came together to form a planet. Here, we find worlds like Pluto, once our 9th planet, now reclassified as a dwarf planet alongside its siblings, Eris, Haumea, and Makemake. These aren't just dead ice balls, they're complex worlds with atmospheres, mountains of water ice, and nitrogen glaciers. They are time capsules from 4.5 billion years ago. For years we explored this region with our telescopes, cataloging its inhabitants. We sent the New Horizons probe on a historic flyby of Pluto, and then aimed it deeper, toward a strange snowman-shaped object named Arrokoth. It gave us our first up-close look at one of these primordial bodies. Everything seemed to be adding up. Our models of the solar system were holding strong. But the more we looked, the more we realized the chaos in the dark had a deeply disturbing pattern. The first clue that something was seriously wrong came from the outcasts. Astronomers began tracking a strange class of objects known as extreme trans-Neptunian objects, or ETNOs. These are bodies from the Kuiper Belt that have been thrown onto truly bizarre orbits, swinging out to hundreds of times the Earth-Sun distance. The dwarf planet Sedna was the first of its kind ever found. A lonely world on a wild 11,000-year journey, so far from the Sun, it barely feels its warmth. But Sedna wasn't alone. As more of these extreme objects were discovered, a startling pattern emerged. Their orbits, against all odds, were clustered together. Imagine throwing a handful of marbles onto a spinning plate. You'd expect them to scatter everywhere. But what astronomers saw was the equivalent of all the marbles inexplicably ending up in the same corner of the plate. Not only were their orbits all pointing in roughly the same direction, but they were also tilted at a similar angle, as if herded by an unseen shepherd. The laws of physics said this shouldn't be happening. Neptune's gravity could explain some of what we see in the inner Kuiper Belt, but it wasn't nearly strong enough to corral these distant objects. The probability of this clustering being a random fluke was found to be incredibly small. Something else, something massive, had to be out there, silently pulling the strings. In 2016, two astronomers at Caltech, Constantine Batygin and Mike Brown, put forth a daring hypothesis. Brown is famously known as the man who killed Pluto, since his discovery of Eris, a dwarf planet more massive than Pluto, forced us to rethink what a planet is. Now, he and Batygin were proposing a new, true ninth planet. They ran countless computer simulations to figure out what could be causing the strange, synchronized dance of these distant objects. Their conclusion was as elegant as it was shocking. The evidence was best explained by a giant planet, a Planet 9, lurking in the darkness. According to their models, this world would be a super-Earth or a mini-Neptune, perhaps 5 to 10 times the mass of our planet. But its orbit would be unlike anything we know. It would be on a hugely stretched out path, taking it hundreds of times farther from the Sun than Earth. A single year on Planet 9 could last between 10,000 and 20,000 Earth years. From its distant home, its immense gravity would act like a cosmic puppeteer, slowly aligning the orbits of those smaller objects over millions of years, creating the exact clustering we see today. Batygin and Brown's model didn't just solve the clustering problem, it also made a stunning prediction. It suggested that Planet 9's influence would create a second group of objects, tilted on orbits nearly perpendicular to the rest of the solar system. Incredibly, when astronomers checked the data, they found a handful of objects that fit this prediction remarkably well. The evidence was mounting. The cosmic detective story now had its prime suspect. Of course, proposing a planet is one thing. Finding it is something else entirely. If Planet 9 exists, it's impossibly far away and incredibly faint. Reflecting so little sunlight, it's nearly invisible to most telescopes. The search is on, and it's one of the greatest astronomical challenges of our time. Scientists are using a two-pronged attack. First, they continue to sharpen the theory. Using supercomputers, Batygin, Brown, and other researchers constantly run new simulations, testing how Planet 9's gravity would sculpt its surroundings. Every new extreme object they discover is another clue, another data point that helps them narrow down the planet's potential mass and where it might be in its long orbit. While the idea is still debated, some recent analyses suggest the clustering isn't a coincidence, with one study claiming the evidence for Planet 9 is now at a 5 sigma level of confidence, a high bar in physics. The second part of the attack is the direct search. Astronomers are using some of the most powerful telescopes on Earth, like the Subaru telescope in Hawaii, to scan the skies. They're looking for a single, faint, slow-moving dot in the vast darkness where their models predict the planet might be. They've already surveyed huge swaths of the sky, ruling out large portions of the area where the planet was predicted to be, which ironically helps to further constrain its possible location. But the real game changer is now on the horizon. The Vericy Rubin Observatory in Chile is expected to begin its full decade-long survey of the sky in late 2025. This next-generation telescope will scan the entire southern sky every few nights with unprecedented depth and speed. Many scientists believe that if Planet 9 is out there, the Rubin Observatory will find it within its first few years of operation. The hunt may soon be coming to an end, one way or another. While the hunt for Planet 9 continues, our exploration of this dark frontier has already revealed a region far more mysterious than we ever imagined. Data from the New Horizons spacecraft suggests the Kuiper Belt might be more extensive than we thought, possibly showing evidence of objects out to 80 astronomical units or more. Some discoveries even hint at a potential second Kuiper Belt, separated from the first by a strange empty gap. And far beyond the Kuiper Belt lies an even more enigmatic realm, the Oort cloud. It's not a belt, but a theoretical, colossal sphere of trillions of icy bodies thought to surround our entire solar system, reaching out almost a light year into space. We've never seen it directly, but we infer its existence because it's the source of the long-period comets that sometimes fall toward the Sun. Planet 9, if it exists, would orbit in the vast, lonely space between the Kuiper Belt and the theoretical inner edge of this ghostly cloud. The existence of Planet 9 would answer so many questions. How did it get out there? One idea is that it could be a lost fifth giant, a planetary core that formed alongside Jupiter and Saturn before being violently flung out into the darkness. Or maybe it was a rogue planet, wandering through interstellar space that was captured by our sun's gravity long ago. Finding it would not only complete the census of our own planetary family, but also revolutionize our understanding of how solar systems form and evolve all across the galaxy. It would prove that even our own backyard is still full of colossal secrets, waiting in the dark to be discovered. What if the suspect is innocent? Some scientists think the strange orbits might not be caused by a hidden planet at all, but by the combined pull of an undiscovered disk of icy material, while others argue it could be an illusion, patterns created simply by where and how we're looking. The evidence for Planet 9 remains circumstantial yet compelling, placing us at a thrilling crossroads in discovery as we peer into a frozen frontier we were never meant to see. The clues are there, etched into the warped paths of worlds at the edge of darkness. So, what seems more likely to you? A hidden giant planet shaping the solar system's edge, or a cosmic phenomenon we've yet to comprehend? The answer waits out there, in the cold and the silence. If this hunt through the outer darkness pulled you in, hype this video up. Smash that like button, share it with everyone who loves the unknown, and help spread this cosmic mystery beyond the edge of our solar system. Let's make the universe wonder what we'll uncover next.